In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We're sad now to gather. Paul, and Ryan, and Tom, and Sherry's sister, Kamara, and all the friends and neighbors and Moorabbi fellow workers and so on to celebrate her funeral mass here today. Above all, we're remembering her. We're expressing our appreciation with her family of her. We're thanking God for the special gift she was to her family, her husband and sons, and her vocation in life as a mother. Lord, have mercy on her. Our funeral mass in our Christian Catholic faith has a great tradition of gathering together all the goodness of a life and presenting Sherry today to the Lord in a spirit of thanksgiving. We begin admitting our own faults and failings, as we all say, I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. On behalf of all of us, O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Sherry, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. We'll all sit now for the celebration of God's word today. Some of the family members have the readings for us.
First reading, a reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare all the peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away their tears from every cheek. He will take away the people's shame. Everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. The day it will be said, see, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult, we rejoice that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
Lord, is my shepherd. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 14 to chapter 5, verses 1. We know that he who raised the Lord Jesus to life will raise us with Jesus in our turn and put us by his side and you with us. You see, all this is for your benefit, so that the more grace multiplies among people, the more thanksgiving there will be to the glory of God. That is why there is not weakening on our part. And instead, though this outer man of ours may be falling into decay, the inner man is renewed day by day. Yes, the troubles which are soon over, though they weigh little, train us for the carrying of a weight of eternal glory, which is out of all proportion to them. And so we have no eyes for things that are visible, but only for things that are invisible. For visible things last only for a time, and the invisible things are eternal. For we know that when the tent that we live in on earth is folded up, there is a house built by God for us, an everlasting home, not made by human hands, in the heavens. The word of the Lord.
Stand now for the gospel reading. Lovely to see a full church now today after our 2 years of not being free to attend funerals. Our parish church here, one of the things I love about it, the many things, but one of the things I love is the smashing stained glass window at the back. I'm just going to read the gospel extract that refers to that. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. The Gospel of the Lord. We'll just sit down now for a few moments. A little short, little reflection. And our Mass here today, Sherry, we are remembering you and we are praying for you. And Paul, Ryan and Tom and Tamara are here in the front, leading us in a way in the prayer. I associate, Sherry, all back along over the years, with her big, happy smile always. That's the first thing I associate her with, her big, happy smile. And then, of course, I think of the three men in her life, Paul, Ryan, and Tom. And her sister Tamara, of course, too, and the friends and relations who are here especially to be with them. And the special guests that stayed for the electric picnic times. Then there's the whole phase of her work in Moore Abbey and how respected she was by staff and residents alike. Could go on and on, but Sherry will be missed, and missed mostly by her own. Then you couldn't go away from her name without thinking of her at the matches, all the way up from juvenile to senior and county. The English lady excited about Strampelly. And why not? I just want to go back for a second to the three men here in the front. Paul and Ryan and Tom. It was lovely to hear them in their home speak so well, so fondly, so endearingly about Sherry in recent days. How much she meant to their lives, how much her motherhood and as a wife, how much all that meant to them. And therefore, how sad they are today. She was so family conscious. Probably over the years of sickness that she had to endure, prepared her to be so kind and considerate for the patients and residents that she cared for in Moore Abbey. The lads showed me a little clip on the television of Sherry cheering and her excitement at a Strathbally County final. Be one of their treasured souvenirs of her. The funeral mass, unfortunately, always too, as a great element of farewell. Farewell to Shelley in this life. And so it's an occasion then too of expressing our appreciation of her, remembering her, and a prayer, an occasion of thanksgiving. Naturally, Paul's gratitude is for a wife, the wife he lived with and loved. Ryan and Tom, their gratitude for Sherry's motherhood and all she meant to them. Whole family, her sister and friends, remembering the younger days when she was with them. So today, as we just reflect for a moment at this Mass, Sherry always had a lovely, cheerful smile that expressed her happiness about the people with her in life and the people she worked for and with. And we were saying in our prayer today, Sherry, bring that smile and happiness with you into eternal life, where you may rest in peace. Amen. We'll all stand now, and some of the family members have the prayers of the faithful for us.
Our prayer today at this Mass is to thank God for the special gift we had in Shiel. A wonderful wife, wonderful mother, worker and a friend. Lord, hear us.
Those who bear the cross of pain in mind and body may never feel forsaken by God. Lord, hear us. Lord, bless with your caring love all who helped Sherry in her life, her work, and her home, and especially during her illness. Lord, hear us.
For Sherry's family and friends, whose lives she's enriched so deeply, who are gathered here today in remembrance of her life, Lord, hear us.
That all of us who are grieving the loss of Sherry may be consoled and strengthened at this time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, as we remember and pray for Sherry today, we ask that you welcome her into eternal life, where there will be no more sickness or pain, only the fullness of love forever. Lord, hear us.
Sit now for the offertory. And I forgot now, sorry, as I forgot at the beginning of Mass that they were bringing little reminders of Sherry to the altar. So I'll do that now, the reminders to the altar first. We'll do the reminders first for Tom.
I would now like to ask for some family members to bring some mementos of Sherry to the altar. Paul first. Paul brings up a family photograph. Sherry was a wonderful wife and a loving mother. We remember all the great times they shared as a family. Ryan brings up one of Sherry's paintings. Sherry was very creative. She wrote poems, drew and painted pictures, and shared them with us. Her art reflects her colourful personality. Tom brings up a Stradbally jersey of the 2016 county final. Sherry was a great supporter of Tom and Stradbally GAA. Could always hear her on the sideline cheering on Stradbally and her beloved Tommy boy. Lee, Sherry's brother, brings up a photograph of the family dog Archie. Sherry loved her animals almost as much as she loved her family. She enjoyed walks with the dogs and sometimes the cat, looking out from the hill over Stradbally and the home that she and Paul built together.
Up there, I missed a penalty there. I'm forgetting it, but we'll have the wine and water now to the altar, Tom and Ryan, the wine and water. Pray now, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Sherry, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We can kneel now for the Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit on them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember your servant, Sherry, whom you have called from this life to yourself. Grant that she who was united with her Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. We stand now again and say together the words our Lord has given us. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ, with the kingdom. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Say the word and my soul shall be healed. Body and blood of Christ, keep me safe for eternal life. Let us pray. At a funeral mass, it's very appropriate, especially people. It's so good to make the effort to be here and to be with the family, that we take a moment now at Holy Communion time to say our own personal, private prayer today for Sherry. May she rest in the peace of love with God. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Sherry, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. We'll sit now for a moment and Paul, say a word or two.
Okay, I have to try and stand up and be counted here today. Okay. I'm not the vocalist of the family, and I've not been, it's been by the sides of the line of Johnny Strably game, up and down the line, you know who was, Sherry was. She loved the community here in Strably. She loved everybody in the community, and I'm here to say thank you for everybody coming today, and the boys, and I really appreciate all the support. Not just over the last few weeks, but the last 25 years we've been here. So I'd like you to just do something for me. I'd like you to all hold your hands up, have an imaginary glass in your hand, and just say, whether it's half full, half empty, to Sherry. To Sherry. Thank you, Ken. Thank you.
Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended now. We stand now for the farewell prayers, please. Thank you all very much. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Receive her soul and present her. Saints of God, come to our aid. Come to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take her to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Sherry in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We thank you for the blessings you have bestowed on her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us, listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Sherry, your servant. In the sight of this world she has died. In your sight she lives forever. Forgive whatever sin she committed, and in your goodness grant her everlasting peace and rest. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The incensation.
Thank you for all joining us here. We have a short service here at the crematorium. You have just been listening to a piece of music called Hallelujah, performed by Colin Hill. But we chose that because the original was by Leonard Cohen, who was one of Sherry's favourite artists when she was a teenager. We've decided to share three poems with you today. Ryan is going to speak first. Come on, Ryan.
So the night that we found out Mum was going to pass, and I couldn't sleep, so I sat in the hotel lobby and I wrote Mum a poem. So, 1991 it was, the first day I knew I loved you. Dancing and smiling always, you raised me right. Cuddles and crayons, planes and trails, rights, wrongs and tails. You picked me up and gave me hope. You gave me hope and true love. Your kindness blossomed and roses grew with a single touch. Birds sang as you opened the door. The sun has got his hat on and he's coming out to play. You sang a song of sixpence and said it was all okay. You are always my best friend. My heart fills with awe and your smile shines on. I am your sunshine, sunshine. I don't know if by that you meant my head or my heart, but I know when I think of you, we can never be apart. My memories of plenty, you've taught me everything I know, shouting, you great prune, or building things from snow. You will never be forgotten, Mama. I see you, I love you, we all love you, you are loved. We, your family, look down on us from above. Thanks.
Okay. Our second poem, we chose this because when we read it, we thought, this is something that Cher might have written, and Andrea is going to read this. This is called If I Should Go by Joyce Grenfell. If I should die before the rest of you, break not a flower, nor inscribe a stone, nor, when I'm gone, speak in a Sunday voice, but be the usual self that I have known. Weep if you must, parting is hell, but life goes on, so sing as well. I wanted to say a few words about Cher, and I thought I might write a traditional eulogy, but the words just didn't come. And I tried writing a poem, but I was even worse at that. But then a couple of nights ago in my room at Windy Gap, I was sitting up in bed, and on the wall opposite me was a plaque. And it has three lines to it, and I thought, oh, here's what I want to say. So the plaque starts with the heading family, and I thought, if I substitute that with the word Sherry, then these three lines tell you all you need to know about her. So the first line says, a little bit of chaos. So Paul was telling me when Sherry first went to see his flat, he was a bit nervous, but it was very tidy. Everything was in place. He invited Sherry in, and she went in, and she pulled all the cushions off the sofa, put them on the floor, pulled all the CDs out of the rack, threw them around. He says, there. It was too tidy, Paul. You need to relax a bit. So, Sherry, a little bit of chaos. The second line is a little bit loud. So we've already heard about Cher on the sideline, cheering along, Strabbley and Tom. But she was never afraid of voicing her opinion, especially if it involved a referee. So even when she was in a pub full of Irishmen watching England play Ireland in rugby, she'd still be shouting and cheering for England. Although the rest of the time, she was in Ireland. So Sherry, a little bit loud. And the last line is, and a whole lot of love. There are too many anecdotes for me to choose one to illustrate that. And I think the number of people here, the number of people at the church, the people watching on live stream and who are with us virtually and spiritually is a testament to that. So share. A little bit of chaos, a little bit loud, and a whole lot of love. So we have, I'd like to share the third poem with you. And then after the poem, we're going to listen to a song which was very special to Sherry and Paul. This poem was written by Helen Lowry Marshall, and it's called Afterglow. I'd like the memory of me to be a happy one. I'd like to leave an afterglow of smiles when life is done. I'd like to leave an echo whispering softly down the ways of happy times and laughing times and bright and sunny days. I'd like the tears of those who grieve to dry before the sun, of happy memories that I leave when life is done.
I am not in love, but I'm open to persuasion. It's always worth the best for romance with a friend. I can smile, but with a lover I could hold my head back. Really loud. Thank you.
You know that's what I'm like.